A truly intelligent person is one who can pretend to be a fool in front of a fool who pretends to be intelligent. Because an intelligent man will successfully fulfill many accomplishments and yet will be willing to learn more. And today we will read a story of such an intelligent man whose name was Gopal. Hello everybody and welcome to Revision Learning. Today we will start the story naming Gopal and the Hills of Fish, which is the third chapter of your English 1 book Honeycomb for the class 7 students. So before moving to the story, let us first know that who is this man Gopal. Gopal Chandra Pramanik, or also known as Gopal Bhar, was a court jester in the medieval West Bengal. He was the court jester in the kingdom of Raja Krishnachandra, then the king of Nadia in the 18th century. Gopal used to give joy to others by laughter and ridicule. The king considered Gopal as a Navaratna of his court. Gopal was a very intelligent person and was keen on his ideas. His stories are very much popular, short, beautiful, humorous, and always had a specific social message. Now, let's come back to our today's story. This story, Gopal and the Hills of Fish, is funny in its tone and nature and is presented in the comic form. Let's see the lead characters in the story. Gopal, Gopal's wife, the king, and courtiers. Here courtiers means the advisor of the king. Before you get into the realms of the story, you must know that Hilsa is a popular fish found in the rivers of India. It's mostly salt during monsoon season. In the story, the season is probably of the monsoon. In the kingdom, everyone seems talking about the Hilsa fish. Why? Because it was the season of the Hilsa fish. Fishermen catching no other fish in particular but only focusing on Hilsa fish. Even in the market, fish merchants selling Hilsa in great gusto. You can see in the front page of your story, fishermen's or the fishmongers sold nothing but Hilsa fish. And the householders could talk of nothing but Hilsa fish. That means everybody was only talking about the Hilsa fish. The height of popularity reaches inside the king's palace. Even the ministers and the courtiers found gossiping and discussing Hilsa fish. You can see here, Your Majesty, you should have seen the huge Hilsa I caught. It was means everybody in the courtiers was talking only about the Hilsa fish. All this stupidity made the king angry. He wanted it to be stopped as soon as possible. The king is even shocked to find Gopal talking about the Hilsa fish also. Gopal is a courtier in the court, as I told you earlier. The king challenged Gopal to bring Hilsa fish in the palace without getting hyped about it. You can see in the textbook here, when the king was angry, he shouted on his courtier. After that, everyone felt silent. Then the king said sorry to all the courtiers, and he said that not even Gopal can stop anyone from talking about the Hilsa fish, not even for 5 minutes. And then the Gopal said, "Oh, I think I could, Your Majesty." The king then challenged him, and Gopal finally accepted the challenge. A few days later, Gopal gets half shaven and smears ash on his face and takes on torn and dirty clothes. Now he looks like a filthy beggar. His wife opposes him, but he listens nothing. Gopal's wife was shouting like anything, "Listen to me, Please, you cannot possibly go out in those disgraceful rags. What are you up to? And then Gopal said to his wife that how many times must I tell you, woman, I am out to buy a huge hills of fish. His wife thought Gopal has gone mad. Gopal then bought the hills of fish and started to walk towards the palace. No one was talking about the hills of fish that the Gopal bought, because his attire was so much disgraceful that everyone was talking about only Gopal. See here, that boy was telling to his mother, "Mother, look at that man. Isn't he comical?" Because yes, Gopal was looking like a comic book guy. Some others said he must be a mad. Some said, "I think he is a mystic," because everyone was only talking about Gopal. When Gopal reached the court, the guards asked him, "What do you want?" The Gopal said, "I want to see the king." But the guards didn't allow him to enter the palace. Why? Because he was not recognized by the guard. The guards thought that he is just a beggar who brought a hills of fish with him. So the guards didn't allow him to enter the palace. Gopal then began to dance and sing loudly because he was almost successful in his challenge that the king gave him. Inside the palace, the king, when heard everything, he wanted to see that man. So he ordered his guards to bring that man to the palace. Gopal was brought before the king, and the courtiers recognized him and said, "It's Gopal." The king was also surprised to see him in that manner. The other courtiers started to crack jokes on him. Some said, "This man has lost his mind. He is totally mad." Gopal then said to the king that he owned his challenge. The king asked, "What challenge?" Gopal then said to the king that strangely, from his journey to the fish market to the palace, no one even bothered that what he was carrying off. Instead, everyone was talking about him who was just looking like a rat picker or beggar. No one said a single word about hills of fish. Then only the king remembered the challenge he had thrown to Gopal. In a very cunning way, Gopal accomplished his challenge, and the king was very happy on Gopal. He said, "Gopal, congratulations, you have achieved the impossible once again." So I hope that everybody has understood this story of Gopal and the hills of fish. Now let's come to the moral of the story. Gopal had no need to take up the challenge, as he was the courtier in the king's palace. He could have declined it and continued leading the luxurious life as usual. However, Gopal cared about his king and his feelings, and thus he took up the challenge. Yes, the challenge was not huge. It proved that during the times of emergency, Gopal would definitely help his king and the people of the kingdom. Another moral is that taking challenge in life is good and makes one popular. A person like Gopal, who has been appointed on the higher rank of courtier, is so down to earth that he literally dressed like a beggar. Never run away from the challenges. Be open to them and accept them like a brave man. Now let's give the character sketch of Gopal from the story Gopal and the Hills of Fish. Gopal was a very famous courtier in the palace of the king. He was brave and bold, and when the time came, he did not shy away from taking the challenge. Rather, he went ahead, got into the form of a beggar, and brought the Hills of Fish inside the palace without being raising a hype about it. Gopal was a very simple and down-to-earth person. Otherwise, people at the courtier position do not go to such low levels just to impress their king. The challenge that Gopal took suggested that he could take any form or resemblance to help the people of his kingdom. Because of good values, Gopal is favorite of the king. So I hope that you have understood this beautiful story, Gopal and the Hill Safir. Okay students, so today here I am signing off. Keep studying and thanks for watching.